So now we're in video number two of our Aero Pilates Reformer. I want to say performer, reformer. Rebecca's going to tabletop her legs because now we're going into arm work. So I'm going to keep it for her on three cords, but a lot of people, this is your very first time, brand new reformer for you. A lot of people need to go down to two. And then you can eventually do a few exercises in three and then bring it back down to two. But she's strong enough, she can do it in three. And if she gets tired, she can just say tap out and I will lower it for her. So your hands go into the strap. She's got her beautiful tabletop legs. Her knees are hugging together here. Her powerhouse is pulled in and she's got her arms nice and long. She's gonna bring them down by her side. And her elbow is not gonna touch the carriage. She's gonna keep it just like that. She's gonna work the triceps. So she's gonna bend her elbow and press it nice and straight. And she just bends and presses it straight. So it's really simple. You don't want your elbows to splay out to the side. You want to reach long through the fingers. Good. You're trying to keep any tension out of your face, neck, and shoulders. You're trying to put everything in your powerhouse and your arms. Two more. There's 10. So now she's going to keep them long, and they're going to go straight up to the ceiling so we can work the deltoid. So she's going to come down to her hips, right back up to the ceiling. And hips, and ceiling. Perfect. Three. So from there, we go into circles. So she's going to come up to the ceiling, but now she goes to the side, back to the hips. So it's ceiling, sides, hips. So it's just a big circle. You just want to make sure when you're doing this that you're not letting your hands go below the height of the reformer. You're keeping it just level with the body. And you don't want the hands to go so far back that you hit the stoppers. And you'll know if that happens, you'll feel that little stop. One more, and then you reverse it. So you go hips, side, ceiling. Hips, side, ceiling. The second one is usually what starts to get a bit harder. And that's a lot of times too when your legs, instead of hugging the knees together, they'll try to open, they'll try to pop open, they'll try to drop. Really try to make sure that powerhouse is pulled in, it's not taking over your back, and you're still hugging those knees together. More. And then she's going to let the carriage come all the way into the stopper. I'm going to take these and she can hug her knees into her chest if she wants to, and then she's going to step off so we can go into an ab series. For the ab series, it's the half roll back. So you're going to lower your headpiece, you're going to get rid of the foot bar. And depending, if you are brand new to this, I would highly suggest having four or three cords on because it will assist you. But for Rebecca, we're going to take it down to two because she has been practicing this for a while. Queen Elizabeth. So you're going to set your feet right here. You're going to sit on the carriage at a hand's distance from the back. So just put your hand down and measure. That's where your bottom's going to go. Your knees are bent and your feet go onto the headpiece. All right, and then we take the hands and put them into the straps. Now this is a tough one. There's two different types of breathing. There's movement that goes along with it. And whenever we put something in our hands, we usually want to use our arms, not for this exercise. Pretend you don't even have arms. You want to get a nice stretch through the back. So if you look at Rebecca, she's got nice long arms and she's sitting up really tall. We call this the Queen Elizabeth. It's almost as if she has a crown on her head. That's where you start, inhale. And then exhale, she brings her chin into her chest and she's gonna scoop her belly down and she rolls back almost like she's gonna lay down and she looks like the letter C. We call this C is for cookie. Inhale and hold. Exhale, she's gonna bring that C shape up. But then at the last minute, she inhales nice and tall, she's Queen Elizabeth again. So there's a lot of movement there. Exhale, scoop the belly, roll down. Inhale, hold. Exhale, bring that C shape up. Inhale, nice and tall, beautiful. Exhale, scoop, roll it down. Inhale, exhale, bring it up. Inhale, top. So she's going to do the next two, and I'm going to yap around her. So a lot of people have a tendency when they're here, especially trying to get up, they bend their elbows and try to use their arms. Just notice she's not doing that. She's keeping her arms nice and straight. Got one more. So really watch for that. Watch if your arms are trying to do any work. This should all be about your powerhouse, and that's why you might want to add extra cords. Okay. We'll do the twist one today. So her hands are going to go together. You're going to bring your hands together so they're both holding the same strap, and then you drop your knees together to one side. It doesn't matter which side. Okay. Same thing. You inhale tall. You exhale, roll down. But when you take that inhale, you switch your legs to the other side. Inhale, exhale up, inhale top. Exhale, roll it down. You find that C curve on the diagonal. Inhale, switch the legs. Exhale, bring it up. Inhale, nice and tall. Exhale, roll it down. Inhale, switch. Exhale, bring it up. And again, she's not using those arms. Inhale, tall. Exhale, roll it down. We've got one more each side. And switch. Exhale, bring it up. She's letting the carriage and her abs take her. Last one. Exhale, roll. Inhale, switch sides. Exhale, come up. Inhale, nice and tall. Okay. We're just going to take these and we're going to throw them on the floor. While she turns around, she's going to put her hands on the metal pieces, the rails, and your knees are going to go right against the shoulder box. For this one, you want to take it down to one cord. We want it really light. This is the one lots of people like to cheat when they're doing this. They use their arms and their legs for everything. So really watch this one carefully. She's set up beautifully. She has her hips over her knees, her shoulders over her wrists. Her head is in line with her spine, so it's beautiful here. And the muscles she's looking to work are right here, the navel and pubic bone. That's it, nothing else. No legs, no hip flexors, nothing. So she's going to come, and she's just going to engage her lower abdominals, and she's going to try and pull the carriage in. And it doesn't matter if the carriage moves or not, because she's trying to use the correct muscle. So a lot of people will just get the carriage to move, and they're using any old thing. Their shoulders might go in front of their wrists. Their hips might come in. She's really trying to find those muscles. And the newer you are to this, or if you've had a C-section or babies, a lot of times this can be a real big challenge. Also check for gripping. If you're really using your arms, if you're gripping your hands, if you're scrunching up your face, you're using extra muscles that don't need to be used. All right, get it to move, Rebecca. So if you see that, that moved a little bit, but she's using the correct muscle. So it doesn't matter that it didn't come all the way up to her hands because she didn't cheat at it. So I can't stress that enough. I know a lot of people just want to move it, but you really want to use the correct muscle. One more. So that's fantastic because she's really making sure she's using the right ones. She's going to walk her hands a little bit closer, and this is the round back one. So she's going to push her upper back to the ceiling. It's almost like she looks like a ball, and she's going to try and make her ball smaller. So she's just trying to get the carriage to move the tiniest little bit without collapsing the upper back. That's the hard part. A lot of people flatten it right out. Perfect. And when we do other videos and we're doing this again, you're going to notice a difference. You will be able to move it a lot more. So you'll get to see, if you learn it correctly, that you do gain that strength. And one more. Keep pushing the upper back to the ceiling, strength drop. Good. So from there, go ahead and come on off. We're going to go all four cords, and we're going to grab the short box. So if your shorter, I would say 5'5" and under, you're gonna put it in front of the shoulder blocks. If you're taller than that, it goes behind. And then just make sure it's even on both sides. So Rebecca's gonna come and sit in the center of the box facing this way, and her feet will go underneath the strap. All right, she's gonna spread her feet wide, and then she's gonna make sure that instead of pressing the carriage, she's gonna, if she needs to move back at all, she's gonna lift her booty up and move herself back so that she's not pushing the carriage. Round back is first. Your hands go outside of your hips. You round your upper back like you're texting. And then you just make sure there's a little space underneath your chin, like there's a little apple underneath there. The body stays exactly the same. So she's gonna inhale here. Exhale, she's gonna take this shape back. Inhale, she's gonna hold it. Exhale, she takes the shape up. That's it. So it's inhale, exhale the shape back. Inhale and hold. Exhale, bring it up. And again, back. Inhale, hold. Exhale, up. Inhale, finish. She's got two more. So it's the same breath pattern you'll see in a lot where you have a moving exhale and a holding inhale. At first it's confusing, but you will get it. Now let's add the flat back. So she's gonna come out of that round back position, and you should have some kind of a pole. Usually the box and the pole are sold together. Mine is extra long, it's a gondola pole, but whatever, still works. All right, so she's gonna reach straight out in front of her. She plugs her shoulders in, and then she's gonna try to open up her shoulders, and she try to move the hands further apart, even though they don't actually go anywhere. She's inhaling nice and tall. Exhale, coming back. Inhale, hold, and exhale, up. Inhale, tall. Exhale, back. Inhale, hold. Exhale, up. Her posture is gorgeous. Inhale. Exhale, inhale tall, exhale back, inhale. She's got one more and she's doing an awesome job. Nice. So one thing I like to do is I'm gonna give her a little stretch. But what you could do is have your foot bar still on and you just grab the foot bar and you give yourself a stretch. We'll show that next time. All right, so that's our second video with all the ab series in it. So just stay tuned for the next video.